Good afternoon. Tonight I was checking the Google and see if there is any other similar simulation tools like Space Engine and Universe Sandbox, which I'm using to create my videos. I was wondering if there is any other tools which is working similar to these two strong tools. And I found this list, so I would try these softwares also in my videos and show you the results. As the first one, I want to check the Stellarium. This Stellarium, I already checked, it has a software based on, I think, Android and iOS, which also it has a web-based software, web-based version. And I was checking the web-based version and I saw it's fantastic. It's a great software which you can see and use. It's some sort of a real-time software. I mean, you can set your location from here, or also it itself, it can find yourself, find you, and based on your location, it would see you can see the stars in the sky and maybe analyze some of them. So based on your location, you can see whatever you can see if you are out and try to search in the sky. So for example, in Netherlands, which I'm living, if I stand towards the north, I would see these scenes, these stars, which we can analyze most of them if we go get closer to them. For example, I think this biggest star, this is Polaris. As you know, Polaris is one of the biggest stars which we can see from the Earth each night. And if you stand toward the north, you would see this Polaris. So you can get some data from this Polaris in here. As you can see in the left part, we have the other names, also known as Alpha, Ursa, Minoris. As you know, it's in you can see also the constellations from here. So based on the stars, you can check which constellation it belongs to, and also the other information which may be they're proper and useful. The distance from the Earth is for Polaris is 432 light years, so it's almost close to us in comparison with lots of other stars. And I think it is this 432,000 light years, because I'm not sure. I think, let me check. I will check it later. Let me check now. Polaris distance to Earth. Let me to be sure. Oh, I was typing. Polaris distance to Earth. Oh, this is not 1,000. This is 433 light years. So I was right in the first step. So we can see Polaris here. This is some sort of a close star. I thought it might be 1,000, but it's not. And many other useful information about this star. Also, you can see in which constellation this star belongs to. So we keep continue with this software. Also, we can change your direction. If you get back and zoom out from this star, you can see there are some directions. Right now, we are standing toward the north. If I turn right, this is the east, and I can see the beautiful thing that we can see in here in these nights. This is Jupiter, which is getting closer to Earth. As you know, in 6th and 7th of December, Jupiter would be in the same line with the Earth and Sun. So it would be in the closest situation to the Earth. So don't forget to watch the sky at 6th and 7th of the December. So for now, you can see Jupiter is much, much bigger in comparison with other stars. So some sort of getting closer to Earth. If I get close to Jupiter, I can see the information about Jupiter and also its moons. As you know, Jupiter has around 90 moons in comparison with Earth, which has only one moon. And you can see Europa, which some people say that there would be some maybe life or life likelihood on the Europa. And this is Jupiter. Also, you can scan the sky for other interesting scents. I can see Uranus here. Oh, this is something interesting. Let me show you the bar in here. There is an option which says deep sky objects. If I just turn it on and turn it off, when I turn it on, you can see some deep objects in the sky. For example, we have here the interesting Pleiades, or if I'm pronouncing correct, which is one of the interesting, one of the most interesting objects in the sky. As you know, Pleiades, or we can call them, I think, Messier 45, I think, or Seven Sisters, which I have some information regarding in here. Oh, I had some tabs related to Polaris here, so it wasn't necessary to search in the Google. I have some information from previous studying in my Firefox, so there are lots of information regarding the Polaris, but now I'm looking for the Messier 45, or called Pleiades, or Seven Sisters. As you know, it's related, the distance is more than 400 light years to Earth, and it's related to Taurus. The constellation name is Taurus, and for sure we can find it here. So if I want to see this Pleiades, Pleiades is belong to which constellation, there is an option, interesting option, which I can turn it on in here, constellation. If I just turn it on, I can see the Taurus constellation is here, and one of the objects related to is Pleiades. Also, there is another option with constellation art. If I just turn it on, so now I can see the graphics related to constellations. So Taurus, as you can see, this is Taurus, or the another name is Bull, I think. Let me see, I have already prepared some information for you. The Taurus, yeah, it's here. It's here, Taurus. Well, it says some timing, but the symbol is the bull. So as you can see in the simulation, we have the Taurus, and look like the bull, and the main stars, main objects, actually one of them is this Pleiades, which is itself is a separate word for itself. It's called also Seven Sisters, or Messier 45. It contains lots of stars and different objects, which if you want, you can click on any of them, getting closer to them. In left part, you can see lots of information, the other names related to this star, the type of star, the distance. If I just zoom in this star, I can see it from a little bit closer, but with not lots of details. That's enough, I think, for a web-based software. It's more than enough. I have to try the iOS or Android version also on my laptop, so on my mobile phone, so maybe there would be lots of more details in there. Actually, the details are not as much as the space engine, for example, but also you can see lots of interesting and fantastic information regarding the sky. I'm really enjoying this software, and I keep continue making some videos regarding this this great web-based software. In the middle of video, I just want you to subscribe. If you are here by your Explorer, please just subscribe my channel. and like it, it would be the chance to the others who are interested in this sort of subjects, so they can find me easier, and it would be some motivation for me to keep keep making this sort of videos. And I would try to complete my information regarding these objects, and for sure the future videos would be much better. Let's keep working with this software. So the first object is here is Constellation. If I turn it off, you would see those lines would disappear, but when you turn it on, you can see the lines for lots of constellations. For example, we have Aquarius here, we have Pisces here, Andromeda, and some of the names, maybe I'm making mistakes. Write for me in comments if I'm making mistakes anywhere. Also, we have Lyra, one of the most famous stars, which we can see, and this is really bright. This is Vega. If I click on Vega, I can see it's known also as Alpha Lyra, and the other names, and the distance is quite close to Earth. To ours, it's just 25 light years old. Since I'm saying this is close in comparison with lots of other stars and galaxies, but for sure it's not so close to us, but in comparison, yeah, we can say it, we can call it as a close star. And it says Vega is the brightest star in the northern constellation of Lyra. So this Lyra, I think, has lots of a story for itself. I would check and try to find the interesting stories related to Lyra and create other videos related to it. Also, one of the most interesting constellations is this. We can see Saturn is almost here, Aquarius. If I turn left, the ones which I'm familiar with, I'm looking for them. And yeah, we have Lynx constellation. We have, this is one of the most famous constellation which everyone maybe heard of. It is Ursa Major, and also we have Ursa Minor. Yeah, this is Ursa Minor, which is like a bear. It is big bear, small bear. Let me zoom on it. Okay, Ursa Minor. It says Little Bear. Ursa Minor, another name is Little Bear. Most of us have heard lots of stories related to this Ursa Minor or Little Bear. And you can see Polaris, which I introduced as the first star in this software. It's one of the stars, one of the most famous stars, which is being used for finding the way for everyone who is getting around the Earth. If you want to find somewhere the directions, at least in the night, you can set your direction based on the Polaris. It's famous. Everyone in military service or other places for sure would learn about it. So this is Ursa Minor and famous stars Kochab. Kochab is variable star, also known as Beta Ursa Minoris. And let's get to the Big Bear. Big Bear or Ursa Major. Great Bear. And this is the Angels, where you want to see. In the software, you can see, interestingly, the direction. Right now, I'm standing toward the north. If you are living somewhere else, just click on this part here and set your location. If you want to see, for example, the sky from another view, from another country, also you can set your location here. But for me, it was use auto location. It depends on you. This is a setting you can set whenever you want. If you stand somewhere else, maybe your angle would be different. And lots of interesting, I think each of them can be a subject of a movie. And we have lots of movie, as you have seen, There are lots of interesting movie regarding the Taurus. It's a famous American movie with this subject. It's the son of the god, as you know, and lots of interesting stories. Also the other parts. So we have checked the constellation. This is the lines. Also constellation arcs. They're the shapes. And atmosphere. Yeah, you can turn off the atmosphere, so your type of viewing would be different. You would see like this, without atmosphere. Also, you can set the one of the interesting parts which I was seeing in this software is this landscape. If I just click on it, you would see you turn it on, you would see the ground, and you wouldn't see the other parts. In other parts of the earth, which you can see normally, but if you just turn it off, you would see other part of the earth also. So for now, if I turn it on, I cannot see the other parts, which for example the moon. Yeah, this is the moon, which for now I cannot see the moon, but I think this is just the evening. I think in a few hours moon would rise, and I would see the moon. But if I just turn it off, the landscape, I can see also the moon. Oh, there are lots of interesting constellations here. For example, the Cancer. Mars also is right now. It's not related to Cancer, but right now it's somewhere in the middle of the Cancer. So the stars related to the Cancer. Beta Cancri. Accumbens. I think I'm not sure if I have enough information about each of them, but for sure if you are interested, just write in the comments and I would search and bring the stories related to this constellation to you, so we can make other videos maybe with more details about each of this constellation. Because also in Universe Sandbox we have some options related to these constellations. Just write in the comments and I would search and create a video related. Also we have Virgo. For sure you have to test this software. It's great. You can see lots of details, which it was interesting to me the first time which I saw. So don't focus on just Space Engine and Universe Sandbox. They're great, but also we can test the other softwares. Tonight, it was my first experience related to Stellarium, and it was great. For sure, I would check the other softwares too later. And so we had the option Deep Sky Objects, and we saw some Deep Sky Objects. And night mode, we have night mode, so the color would be changed. And there is a full screen option here, so whole your screen would be belong to the software from now on. And this is the exact time, as you can see for me, this is the exact time. So all these stars, all these scenes which I'm seeing, they're actually live, and I'm happy to see that in a live. I'm working in a live software which I can see the actual in actual moment in actual place what's going on in sky. Okay, I don't want to make a long video, so I would continue in other clips and videos. Please write in comments if you like this sort of investigation videos. We would investigate other softwares and try to find the interesting part of each software. For sure we can learn, actually at least myself, I can learn lots of things from the softwares. Write in comments what do you want. It's just enough to keep going with the Space Engine and Universe Sandbox, or it's interesting to find out other softwares too. Thank you very much, have a great night, bye.